Hey guys, Dave Womack here.
Jamieleigh here.
From BirdTricks.com, and we took on a student with a clipped bird who wanted to have this crazy dream of flying it outside. So here we are in Hawaii, making that happen.
Check it out.
My favorite color was blue. And I decided to paint my house blue. Started looking for a bluebird, but I haven't decided yet what kind of bird I was gonna pick. So one day I walked into the store and the pet shop and I saw a sunshine. I saw this blue and gold macaw, and actually it was two in there. And I just like, I found my bird. I got home with the bird, the blue bird, and they put her in a box, like in a pet carrier. They built a cage. I came home, everything was set up. So I put the bird in the cage. And then next morning, I opened the cage, the bird come out. And after I knew I have to put the bird in the cage again. And she didn't want to go in the cage. And I'm like, oh, how you put the bird in the cage? How? And I just like, sunshine, step up, sunshine. I have no idea what to do with the bird. And that thing was just kind of coming day after day. And she was coming on my shoulder. And God, I could not get the bird out of my shoulder. She was biting my finger. And I was just like, okay, come on, come on. And it, that was ridiculous. They say, how can I get a bird that I don't know how to do anything? So I realized her nails was too big. And I say, maybe her nails, I need to clip. So I called the vet. Hey, I have a bird that I need to clip the nails. Okay, you can make an appointment. No, you cannot make an appointment. I need the doctor coming to my house, because she's like, excuse me? No, the doctor's not gonna go to your house. I'm like, but I can't put the bird in a cage. I don't know how I'm gonna get the bird to the vet. And then the lady just told me, well, if you don't know how to control your bird, we cannot help you. And I just, oh, okay. And I'm just like, yeah, I don't know how to control my bird.
Busted. Don't give her treats. Are you giving her treats? You give her the treat before she gets off your shoulder? Claudia, damn it!
Oh.
Try just scraping her off onto the sink.
Yes!
Okay, lay down. No, lay down. On your belly.
My belly?
Yeah, lay down. I know it's gross. Lay down.
No.
Come on, do it. Lay down. Down, down.
Down.
Okay, get up.
Okay.
Go out there.
Is rolling around in the pee?
I didn't know anything about birds, so I just say, okay, 6 months is too a, you know, young age. And she's clipped. I thought that she could not fly. I brought her home. 10 days after, she just jumped out of my lanai here and flew all the way to the beach and crashed on some neighbors. House. And like they told me she doesn't know how to fly. And she just was scary. Very, very scary. And I realized, yeah, she can fly, but she doesn't know how to fly. And I did get that in the beginning, honestly. I just thought that maybe she landed over there. The wind told her over there. I don't know what happened. I know she flew. They told us that she was not gonna fly, but she flew. And then we just started teaching her how to fly herself. Throw the bird. Go, sunshine. She was crashing everywhere. She was crashing in the door, she was crashing in the windows, she was crashing the gate, she was crashing everywhere. Until one day, she make up the gate, and then she crashed in my neighbor's wall. And she cut her face. She scratched her face, and I saw that, and that really breaks my heart. And we need to do something about this bird. She doesn't know how to fly. And that's when I emailed Jamie and I say, Jamie, please help me. My bird doesn't know how to fly. And that's the idea to free fly my bird, okay? Because I was not okay with the bird that was not capable to fly. That's what she's born to do. I still have the video that I sent to Jamie. I was shooting my lanai with the park right in the back, and I say, BondiTricks.com, that's my dream. I want to fly my bird back in that park. I still have that video on my phone. And that was my dream. I just want to be able to take my bird in the park and fly her out there. Maybe take my bike for a ride and she's follow me. And today I can see that she is flying in the backyard. That's her backyard, and she is going there and flying. This is a dream coming. It is totally. The hardest part for the training was realizing that Sunshine doesn't know how to brake. I mean, how to stop. She doesn't know how to descend and stop. And that was the hardest part. We got stuck in that process, in that stage for a long time. And pretty much because we did not have the right space. I kind of provided all the space that I have available in my house. I gave her my dining room, and then it was my second living room was bigger. And then I net my old garage and downstairs, everything. But it's still, she was processing, she was going forward. And then we need the outdoor. We took her to a netting baiting cage, and she was awesome. But we didn't have that here. So we tried to find a space, and the space that I found sucks. Sorry. But I remember Jamie saying, this is not gonna work. But that was the only thing we have. That's the only thing we have. And that makes me think sometimes she will not make it. She was just not gonna make it. That was struggling there. Every day we go in there, every day. We're taking more and more ladders, perch, tennis ball. We're taking everything that helped her take Sunshine out of the bin. So she was just sitting there for like 10 minutes. You rent the space for 1 hour, and maybe she flight time was 5 minutes. The rest was just waiting. Sunshine gets escaped about 3 times. Not intentional, okay? Totally accidental. And one time, I remember Jamie telling me, well, the touch train works, so She did good because she flew off. I'm not gonna tell the story because she's probably gonna yell me. But I hope she forgot about the story. But so Shiny went up into a pine tree, maybe, I don't know, 80 feet tall. And I just stopped the Tony golf course to watch her in that situation. And I have the BirdTricks jacket on. But I did the touch training. And she came down, branch by branch, man. You know, she came all the way down until she was level and secure, and she flew to me. That was great. That was fantastic. But not long time after that, I make a mistake that I did not close my bird cage. I thought I closed, but it did close. And I was going to the gym. 20 minutes later, I got a phone call saying my neighbor, hey, your bird is out. I'm like, what do you mean, my bird is out? Yeah, your bird is out. So I drive all the way back, took another 20-25 minutes to get back in here. And Sunshine was on top roof of the house of my neighbor. We tried to take her out of there. She flew to another palm tree and then to another palm tree. But it was interesting that she was going in a circle. She was not going anywhere, but she was going in a circle. And then she landed to the highest post that we have in the shrimp. And that was 3 hours. 3 hours struggling to try to take her out of there. It was dark by the time we took her out of there.
What about the time you tried to fly her in a tunnel?
That's the time.
Was the
okay.
Don't remember the
she
story.
Was like, don't tell her. Don't. She's gonna kill me.
How is Jamie to work with?
Yeah.
Do you prefer Dave or Jamie? If you could only fly one of them out, would you have only flown Dave?
There's
but
a balance there.
I have to say, in the beginning, I was like, damn it, this girl, my God, nothing that I do is right for her. She's yelling me all the time. And then my goddaughter and my goddaughter's sister was like, what'd she say? Let me see. No, she's yelling me. And then, no, let me see. And then they're like, wow, yes. Don't do that, Jamie's gonna yell at you. Don't do that, Jamie's gonna, I'm gonna tell Jamie. So Jamie become the whole hero. And everything I was gonna do to Sunshine, they're like, Jamie's not gonna like that. Yeah, that's true. So I guess, you know, I have to thank you, Jamie. You know? Like David did the whole thing. I know he had the blood, you know, isn't his blood, I guess. But he's too nice. He's told me so many times. I'm too nice, I guess. She's gonna punch you.
It's so true. I get the non-group message. What do you think Jamie's gonna say about this?
Sometimes I was texting him on the side, hey David, should I say that to Jamie, please? Before I tell her, is she gonna like me? Or is she gonna hate me? You should wait a little bit longer.
But now in hindsight, all those lessons make sense, right?
Yes.
Like us calling you an idiot, you would look back and say, okay, I was an idiot.
No, that Antonio thing. Oh, we're gonna try something really cool. We are here in Toco Bay, and we're gonna try something really cool, okay? With the Sunshine. Sunshine!
video. Ah, oh, sunshine! Whoa!
Sergio Ronnie!
Then I see Sergio and I go, what is Sergio doing there? It's supposed to be Marcella! I'm like...
So one thing that I would like to say very much is that besides the old work, the hard work and efforts that I'll say BirdTricks putting on, we grow a relationship. We become friends. And this is really meaningful. It is. Because today I met Capri. So I know I met the whole family. And they're just more than trained. They will make part of that special moment. And that will be there forever. That will be there forever.
Yaman!
She was a wahini, rocking a bikini, blocking my vacation.